This is the Darkglass Element, a headphone preamp from the future, allegedly, that can do things that even in my wildest dreams I never imagined a headphone preamp would ever do. So let's check it out. My name is Gregor and the bass player for today is Phil Rehm. At this year's NAMM, Darkglass had a bunch of headphone preamps at their booth so people just could try stuff in silence. But those have gotten so much attention that now they've developed this. A headphone preamp. Cool. An impulse response loader. Cool. A Bluetooth supported practice tool. Cool. A thing that allows you to play together with your buddies.
I don't have friends.
A thing that is for the first time not only for bass but equally designed for guitar players as well.
What?
A thing for actually all musicians.
Okay.
A thing that allows you not only to connect to your bass but also to be put in between your amp and your cabinet to grab the signal from there.
What?
Let's try that out. I never expected one of my tube amps to be part of my just toying around with headphones at home setup. But yeah, when you have an attenuator, you can actually do this in silence, no cabinet required, which is really cool. Unless, of course, you have like a 300 watt amp pack, then don't do it. But even with your 300 or even more horsepowered amps, you can use the Element as an impulse response loaded DI. Just don't put it in between your power amp and the cabinet. Put it on the link out of your cabinet instead. But let's go back a step and hear what the Element sounds like with none of that, just the direct signal. Let's have a look at the device. The sleek aluminum design has no physical switches on the upper surface, only four touch-sensitive fields. The virtual faders left and right are the volume for the two headphone outs. Blend in the middle is there to match the volume between you and the music you're playing along to. Below these faders is another field, and this is for the impulse responses. When there's no LED, you're using the direct sound. When you now click on the speaker symbol, you go through the stock cabinet simulations, which you can of course replace with other sounds through the app or the Darkglass suite on your computer. Now let's check the 5 default cabinet sounds that are loaded on the Element. On the right we have the in and the output for either a bass or, as mentioned before, any amp. Then we have a mini switch to adjust the gain for these different sources, followed by an aux in for your Walkman or whatever kids use these days. And finally a USB-C port to connect to your computer. Right now this is only for the desktop app, but according to Darkglass, later down the line after an update, you will be able to use the Element as an interface, and this will of course be the output for that. On the left we have a DI out, a ground lift switch and a black field. This is actually just opening, like a window in the enclosure, to improve the Bluetooth connectivity. In a sense, this is literal Darkglass. On the back we have two headphone outs and the 9V power in. The fun part is how easy all of this works, and I really like these touch sensible parts here. And in theory they even last longer than physical switches, but of course only future will tell if this is actually true. At this point in time the apps or the Darkglass suite aren't ready or updated yet, but this will change within the next days. Here's a small phone grab of the caps list, that's at least something. At the moment there are 25 guitar and bass cabinets in the Element, but Darkglass is already working with other developers and companies, even like third-party suppliers, to license their stuff and put it into the system, which is of course really cool. And of course, you can also include your own impulse responses. Especially with the Bluetooth app coming out, this headphone preamp is a very powerful system. But since the whole thing is so much based on software, of course it can be improved and expanded massively. And Darkglass is listening. The day before yesterday, I had a phone call with Marcos, who is the ruler at Darkglass, and made some suggestions, shared some ideas that I had of things that could be done, like a dry wet option or just assigning different functions to the faders. And yesterday you had a meeting or a phone call with the developer team, and they're already implementing my ideas, which is amazing. And of course, you can do the same thing too. So don't hold back with your ideas, put them in the comment section, and I'm glad they will read all of them. And we might just have to revisit this in half a year to see what this thing has become. So that's it from me today. Thank you very much for watching. If you want to see more of these videos, just subscribe to our channel. We are putting reviews like this out at least once a week. And like this video and do all the things that people do on YouTube, I guess. Yeah. There's a bin collection outside. Is this too loud?